Hey there, Dr. E, Dr. Shauna Eichens, with an exciting device that maybe some of you have seen that I want to chat more about today. So thank you, Nikola Tesla, for this brilliant, one of your many brilliant inventions. You invented the Tesla coil in this high-frequency machine. And I've been using this on so many patients and letting them know that they can also use it at home. So instead of repeating the same thing hundreds of times, I thought I would make this video for you. And if other people care to listen and learn as well, then great. I will give the disclaimer that this is for informational and educational purposes only, is not intended or to be substituted for medical advice, should not be done over metal, near metal, water, or alcohol, and that includes hand sanitizer. So not necessarily notice I have earrings on. As long as I'm not using it right there, I can still use it on my face. So it's not like any metal anywhere. But I found this machine so useful in my personal use and professional practice for everything ranging from acne, blisters, cuts, don't worry, I'm not gonna go through the whole alphabet, tendonitis to mastitis, swollen lymph nodes to stub toes, menstrual pains to muscle strains, hair thinning to collagen bringing, that's a stretch I know, sinus relief and healing on the brief. I mean, who can't benefit from increased circulation, lymph flow, and antimicrobial benefits? That's all of us, right? So whether we have congested lymph here, whether we want to bring some collagen lift to our face, if you have, or one of your children have a burn, acne, I mean, it is powerful. So this is how it works. And I'll post in comments, I can post some suggestions on the machine that I recommend if you want to save some time researching. But you can plug it in, make sure that you have either clean face, dry hands, and I'll use it on my face just so you can see, but this can be used pretty much anywhere on the body. So I plugged it in, I have my hand touching it here, finger, or you can touch anywhere on the skin. So I'll start with my finger, turn on the dial. You'll see, depending on the probe you have, either orange, if it's neon gas in the probe, or purple, if it's argon. And then I never turn it past even halfway. It's not like a more is better thing. But you really, I don't even feel anything. Patients typically say they don't really notice anything. The sound is much more intimidating. So notice I can go right over the eye, which is one of few machines that I can do that with. And the only time I'm gonna lift it off the skin is, let's say I had a pimple or a zit here. There's another probe that I use that's smaller. You can lift off. I'm not feeling the zap. I do feel the zap when I use that smaller probe. But otherwise, if you maintain skin-to-skin contact, you can go all over here. I'm gonna turn this off because I'm distracted when I'm using it and I'm trying to talk to you. So then you just either turn it off when you have your probe to skin contact, or if you take it off, touch your finger there, then you can turn the dial off. I don't recommend using it for more than 10 minutes on anybody for any reason, mainly because you don't want to burn out that coil. Another thing is I don't recommend back-to-back sessions, otherwise you're going to burn out the coil. If it's a tiny area, like I said, a pimple, or if let's say there's a wound here, an open wound, I can go right over it, but since it's such a small area, I may only need to do 1 to 3 minutes there. So follow the instructions, chat with your physician to learn more. Like I said, I'll post some comments, and happy wanding. Oh, and the smell, don't be alarmed by that smell. It's ozone. That's why it has the antimicrobial benefit. And it's, like I said, I've seen so much relief. I look forward to you enjoying those benefits as well. Have a great one.